Hello, everybody. My name is David Pegler. This is your pre-London outlook for February the 3rd, 2009. Happy Tuesday, everybody. Let me take this opportunity quickly to remind you that the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. This is not an alert service. Myself or none of the other currency coaches will make any trade recommendations during the course of a day. But what we will do is conduct some fundamental and technical analysis. Hopefully help you put together some good profitable trade plans. Please remember that trading is always very risky, so do not trade real money until you have a good proven track record of success on a demo account. All right, well, I got this Aussie yen hourly chart up, quick rehash of what we discussed yesterday. All our little yen plans worked out pretty nicely. The pound yen gave us a nice fib entry. It's kind of pre-London territory around 6 a.m. London time. And the Aussie yen trade worked even better. You know, we broke, this is an hourly, I'm showing you now. We had this little price trap for it, if you remember that. We broke out of it. We gave a quick little fib retest, and down she went exactly like we planned. And, you know, here we are, kind of just sitting in no man's land. And this Aussie yen looks a lot like the Euro yen, which I want to show you as our actual trade plan for today. Now, running around the charts, it's quite tricky today, guys. I mean, we a lot of currencies really moved extravagantly yesterday, have now hit support and have hit resistance, meaning that, you know, on the Euro, I'm not going to show you the chart, but the Euro, we hit a four-hour trend line. You know, we rallied up off it the whole way through New York, but now we've hit fibs pointing you to the downside. So we've bounced off support, we've bounced off resistance, and now we're sitting in the middle, and the Euro yen is no different. This is a daily chart that I'm showing you, Euro yen. Okay, if I just zoom in here, you'll notice that we still have not been able to essentially break this bottom. Although we wicked it yesterday, you know, this bottom of, you know, call it 114 is still intact. But now we've bounced up to the 5 EMA, which is exerting pressure down on this currency pair. So if we're going to drop, it needs to happen today, meaning that, you know, we're going to ride this 5. It has, you know, it has to happen on this next daily candle. All right. And that's quite important information. Now, how does one play that? Not easily, all right? Let me show you what I'm looking at. This is a 4 hour, and this is what I'm talking about bouncing off support. You know, we came down, we wicked that daily support, we subsequently rose off the bottom. Well, if you take a fib of the drop, okay, take that to the top, you'll notice that we 382 50% area, which is a very common fib zone, all right? So of this whole drop, we came down, bounced, and now people have tried to sell it. Okay, but if you look at it differently, all right, so remember that all that fibs are for us is a measure of support and resistance, well, in this case, acting as resistance, right? What is resistance? An implied area of selling, right? Supply in the market, okay? And now, if I just really get fib crazy here, if we go to the hourly, you'll notice that now we're fibbed pointing to the upside. Okay, so now we've come and made a 50% pointing things to the upside, all right? In which case, you know, in which case, if we get a now 5A cross on the hourly and start heading up, well, then we have a good shot of seeing, you know, 116.80 and change, which are much deeper retracements of the longer-term move. So we have a classic case of fib wars, and quite frankly, folks, you don't want to get involved in something like this, because if this bottom holds, it's very hard to tell if it is. You know, then we have a shot, you know, around this 116.50 to 116.70 area, which is a much more, you know, a lot of times this will happen, right? You'll bounce at the bottom, you'll go up, you'll hit the first fib level, you'll come down, create what we call a reverse fib, meaning that it's just the reciprocal, you know, it's just a fib pointing you to the upside, okay? Remember, nothing goes in a linear fashion, folks. That's the beauty of Forex, actually, if you know how to use it to your benefit. It's actually a fantastic thing. A linear move is actually one of the hardest to insert yourselves into. All right. But, you know, now we've come down, made this little reverse fib, and we're heading up. You know, we could potentially be heading up to the next fib level. Does that mean that the overall daily downtrend is over? But no, it doesn't. But it's going to create an intraday uptrend, which is arguably already has, right? We now have a higher high. We absolutely have a higher low. Okay, a higher high than this previous little swing here. So, you know, short term, we have redefinition of trend. We have a little uptrend on the hourly, 15-minute, whichever. And, you know, potentially if we're going to be heading up, it's going to be to around that 116.50 to 116.80 area. Okay, now, how are we going to, you know, how are we going to treat this as a trade plan? That's really the question everybody's wanting to know, right? This is what I'm talking about in terms of a quick redefinition of trend. Note the little, you know, these are our swing high. This is our swing low. He has another little swing high. He has a swing low. You know, the minute that we broke above this and have now subsequently made a series of higher lows, all right, we have redefined the little uptrend. Okay, remember, an uptrend is nothing but a series of higher highs and higher lows. Downtrend, a series of lower lows, lower highs. This is important because a dynamic redefinition of trend will actually help you trade, okay? Well, you know, now we have a lower high, lower low, etc., but it's still nothing more than a retracement of yesterday's bigger move, okay? So what I'm looking for now is moving into London, if we can break back above this 200 EMA, call it 115, you know, if we get a comprehensive break above here, a little fib pullback, I'm long. Alternatively, not to get fib crazy, you know, we're gonna get to around this 115.15 area, 115.20, and start to roll over. At that point, you want to be short, because then it's more about playing the daily trend as opposed to playing the 50-minute intraday trend. So it's a tricky time. All right, this is definitely one that's not as cut and dry as yesterday's trade plans. This is absolutely one where you're gonna have to play it by ear. And folks, I think that there's a good shot we could see some upside in the euro yen, looking at 116.50-ish today. Okay, just my two pips on the matter. We're really moving at the moment. We're gonna have to see how we react around this 50% area, because if we roll off here, you know, you want to be short. In that case, you know, we're heading down. Are we gonna challenge some lows? But alternative, we can break above here. You know, and then you take your pullback shot, and you're looking for 116.50 to 116.70. All right? And that's your pre-London outlook. All right? A little bit of fib wars today. It's just what the market's providing us. It's not my favorite setup in the world. Be patient with it today. Let price prove it to you. There's going to be plenty of pips, but let price come to you a little bit, and you won't be sorry. Okay? This has been your pre-London outlook for February the 3rd. My name is David Pegler. Have a good day today, folks, and good luck further.